looks like the Supreme Court is right now locked in this idea of putting GOP in power forever. This new assault on voting rights. This is another problematic story coming from it's the payoff Supreme Court is what I call it. The folks that are working for the GOP. Tell us what's at work here.
Well, just yesterday, the court heard oral arguments in this case of Evanwell versus Abbott, and basically a case out of, no shocker here, Texas, where they want to redo how we count populations in order to redistrict the state so that Republicans always win. What their new proposal is that if you're under the age of 18, if you are not allowed to vote in general, you are not counted as a part of the population when it comes to drawing congressional districts. Now, this obviously disproportionately affects Hispanics, it affects blacks, it affects anyone convicted of a crime, anyone going through the naturalization process. All these people, legal U.S. citizens, but currently not allowed to vote. And suddenly, they don't become people. According to Republicans, these are not people because they don't vote. So we can now redraw these districts to include more Republicans because the population is either under the age of 18 or has a disproportionate number of former, you know, convicted felons or people going through the naturalization process. And what it does is it creates these permanent Republican majorities that they've been trying to create. And look where this is happening. It's happening in Texas. It's happening in Florida. It's happening all across the South. It's also a little bit in New York.
Well,
it's not going to be successful.
No, you find where you have a Republican governor and it's happening. Yeah. That's the cliff note to that. Farron Cousins, again, news weirder than reality. So unfortunately, it is reality. Thanks for joining me.
Thank you.